Leslie.
This is an act that he literally did. This is an act.
I want to take a little bit of time out to say thank you for my wonderful patrons, which you see right here on the screen. If you go to Crimson60620 at patreon.com, you can actually help support the show being shown up on the screen. Thank you. So,
all right, guys. So, remember a couple of days ago, probably I think last time I streamed, or it was last Wednesday or Friday. I forget one. We talked about how Ilhan Omar, Representative Ilhan Omar, would receive like a lot of death threat because of what Bobart actually did. And like Bobart was kind of unapologetic, and what Representative Omar was asking her to apologize in public because the shit that she said was in public, didn't go over real well. But there are some people that are seeing the waning of Trump's political power. And, they're trying to, try to cause a culling in the Republican Party to get away from the more overt racism and hatred and shit like that, and trying to get back to business as usual, as bending over and taking it up the ass from corporations and rich people and shit like that, because there are a lot of rich people's bitches. But anyway, let's actually hear an interesting tale that this next journalist or commentary is actually going to bring to us. And we're going to actually watch his video. If you haven't done so, like, go ahead and watch his video, and I'm going to put it in the chat. Give him a watch. I know for his channel being bigger than mine, go ahead and give him a chat because a watch, because this is actually an interesting video. And let's go.
You never predicted. Dan Crenshaw, well-known Republican, saying something which a lot of people could potentially agree with, literally pulling to pieces the loudest mouths in the room, the Griff.
So this is a video he's talking about, Dan Crenshaw. Now, if you don't know who Dan Crenshaw is, he's I think it was Iraqi war vet. I know he's a vet, and he lost his eye in a combat mission. He's ultra conservative. He's like super conservative. And he has videos of him cosplaying as a Mission Impossible character, like Jack Reacher or somebody like that. But like, yeah, let's see.
Grifters. Who have we got? Bobert. Marjorie Taylor Clown. Gosar. He is on stage, and he has, and bearing in mind he's a Republican, it is incredible what he had to say. Thoughts in the comment section below. Thank you.
Supporting these two. There's actually other veterans in Morgan's race. There's other front runners. But why support these two? Well, because I've been in Congress for almost 3 years now. There's two types of members of Congress. There's performance artists, and there's legislators.
Now, mind you, this is... And let me see if I can pull that video up. Um, Let's see if I can actually do that. This is Dan Crenshaw's like political ad. This is his political ad. So this is his ad that he did. And I don't know if it's actually Damn it. I can't find the ad unmolested. Shit. I want to find the ad unmolested. But he actually does an ad where he cosplays as this whole ass motherfucking maybe it's on this channel. Where he cosplays as this whole ass like Michigan Impossible motherfucker, right? Like he literally cosplays as it. Let's see. 2 months. This shit was like earlier last year. That's 8 months. That's 11 months. Is this it?
Human trafficking is modern day slavery. It is one of the most heinous crimes.
Let's see. What was it? Oh no. Please. I'm just looking. Here it is.
Your mission, should you choose to accept it, will be to save Texas. To do so, you must recruit an exceptional team of congressional candidates. They must be courageous, patriotic, and absolutely
fearless.
To do so, you must recruit an exceptional team of congressional candidates.
Why does it look like on his back? It looks like the Cobra... The Cobra signal. Why does it like the Cobra signal? I just like, wow, okay.
Leslie?
This is an ad that he literally did. Let's see if I can actually, that's his Avenger style ad. What was another one? It was this one. Oh God. This shit was here. Was it this one? This is the shit that he actually did. Who's a performance artist? Who is the performance artist? You guys tell me. Let's just hear it. Okay, sorry.
Now the performance artists are the ones that get all the attention. They're the ones you think are more conservative because they know how to say slogans real well. They know how to recite the lines that they know that our voters want to hear. Let me tell you guys something. In the first 2 years of Trump's presidency, when Republicans were in control, when every single time we were voting on Donald Trump's agenda, who do you think was at the top of that list voting with Trump, and who do you think was at the bottom? A lot of names you would recognize were at the bottom of that list. A lot of names you would recognize are at the top of that list. Number two is it's probably going to make you cringe a little bit.
What was your name at, man? Wait. your performance artist, obviously. What was your name at?
It's Adam Kinzinger. Voted with Trump almost 99%. He was number two. You know who's at the bottom? Everybody in the Freedom Caucus. All of them. What you hear so often is
not- Now, what he's not going to say is the bottom of the Republicans that voted with Trump was like 93, 94, 90. The fuck? He's acting like they're fucking completely disloyal to Trump. But you know, performance artists gotta perform, right?
Not true. It's not true. We have grifters in our midst. Not here, not like in this room. That's not what I mean. I mean in the conservative movement. Lie after lie after lie, because they know something psychologically about the conservative heart. We're worried about what people are going to do to us, what they're going to infringe upon us.
And that's generally the end of it. He said the quiet part out loud, that most Republicans are worried. They're scared about what people are going to do to them. And so they're going to do it to you first. Because reasons. I can't with these people. It is just unbelievable. And it's just like this whole thing of just like, well, I better do it to them before they do it to me. You know, replacement and everything else. And it's like, dude, nobody wants to take your mediocre ass spot. No, we don't. It is fucking stupid that so many people are living in fear because they're afraid. And you know what? Look. Yes, you can say that Dems, liberals, leftists fear certain shit, but we don't actively act as if everybody's coming to get us. Everybody's coming to get us. Because it's stupid. And I don't know what else to say. I just can't be this fucking fearful. But anyway, guys, I want to say thank you for watching today. If you haven't done so, please like, share, and subscribe. Follow if you're watching on Twitch. And yeah, wow, these people were fucking shameful. And also, they don't like you either. They don't like you either. They think you're stupid and fearful. But as I said before, I'm gonna cut this video segment here, and thank you for watching, and peace.
If I gave myself a power, where would I be? Was I